Good evening, and thank you for joining me here this evening as we continue to work our way through Mark's Gospel. We begin this time of fellowship with some words from Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And so we take a few minutes to listen to or even sing along with our opening praise. What a friend we have in Jesus.
All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Heavy trials and temptations, is there trouble anywhere? Be discouraged, take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do your friends despise, forsake you? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield you. Will find a solace there, and you will find a solace there.
Let us pray. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, right at the beginning of this time together, we lift up to you our concerns and worries for families and friends. With COVID on the increase, Lord, we pray for your protection. We give thanks for the many people within our health service who day by day put their lives at risk for us. We thank you for those throughout the world who are working towards a vaccine. We pray for all our governments throughout the world as they continue to work together to bring this pandemic to an end. Lord, we lift up to you those that we know and love who are going through difficult and challenging times. May they feel your presence and your peace with them as we are praying together now. And so, Lord, as we move into this time of worship, we pray, Lord, that you would speak to us through their music and through your words. And so now we join together in saying your prayer, which you taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. A reading comes from Mark chapter 4, verse 35 to 41. Jesus calms the storm. That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side," leaving the crowd behind. They took him along just as he was, in the boat. There was also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified, and they asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." Over the previous weeks, my fellow local preachers have been looking at different aspects of Jesus' ministry, which is recorded in Mark's Gospel. Tonight, we look at Jesus in action through some very familiar Bible accounts that are recorded for us. The overall theme is faith. Each of the accounts recorded here are indeed sermons in themselves, and so for the next few minutes, I wanted to take a look at each of these accounts of Jesus in action and what they can mean for us today. I read the section on Jesus calming the storm, and I do feel sorry for the disciples when Jesus said to them, "Why are you so afraid?" That must have been some storm to frighten the disciples, when you think those same individuals made their living from fishing and therefore would have been well used to storms. They had been around Jesus for some time but failed to see who he was. And I wonder at times, can we be guilty of being so focused on doing church that we're missing God's blessings? The encouraging thing about this passage, even with the disciples' lack of faith, Jesus still calmed the storm. And for us today, if we're in the middle of life's storms, we have a Saviour who will come alongside us to be with us and give us those reassuring words, "Be still and know that I am God." Tonight, we all need to hear the words, "Quiet, be still." In Jesus, we learn to be still. The boat then arrives on the far shore, and we read about Jesus being confronted with a man with demons. In our culture, we don't talk about demons in the way encountered here. However, how many times have we talked about people who are saying that they're fighting every day with their demons? Should that be drugs, alcohol, or gambling, or poverty? In Mark's accounts, when the man opens up to Jesus, he finds peace. It is good to talk. And certainly in these days of COVID, it's important that people talk and support each other. It's good to know in times of difficulty, in Jesus, we find peace. The next two accounts mix in with each other. The woman who'd been to a number of doctors and spent all her money and found no help and still found herself an outcast due to her illness. But she heard the stories of Jesus healing people and made her way to the town. What an incredible witness of faith that she believed just to touch Jesus' outer clothes she would be healed. The woman was not disappointed. The woman found the secret of faith, trusting Jesus and telling him all. What did Jesus say to him? Say to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." You know, when I read through that, I think of the hymn, reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. You will find he's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. He is passing by this moment, your needs to supply. Reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. In Jesus, we find hope. And if you're listening to this evening, maybe you do need to reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. The other part of the story involves the leader of the synagogue, Jairus, who breaks away from the other Jewish leaders to ask Jesus for help in saving his daughter. As while Jesus was heading to Jairus' house, that the events of the woman had taken place and therefore delayed Jesus' arrival. Jairus' servants arrived to tell him not to bother Jesus anymore, as his daughter had died. Jesus encourages Jairus to believe. Do not go on fearing the worst, but do keep believing for the best. His daughter was healed. In Jesus, we find strength. And so as I bring this short time to an end, if we look at the title of chapter 6, A Prophet Without Honour, would make you think there is a sad ending to this section. And indeed Jesus said, only in his hometown among his relatives and in his own house is a prophet without honour. Even with all that they had witnessed, Jesus was amazed at the lack of their faith. Did this stop him? No. In Calming the Storm reading, we heard that Jesus asked the disciples that they have no faith. Yet with their failings, Jesus sent them out in twos to preach to people should repent. They drove out demons and they healed the sick. In Jesus, we find courage when all around us are rejecting the message of Jesus, because we are programmed to think if we can't see or touch or taste, it doesn't exist. But in Jesus, we have the courage to speak and show by example what it is to be a follower of Jesus. The one thing to note from all of us who are involved in the church, Jesus went to the people. As church people, we are called to go, not to sit and wait for people to come to us. We all want and pray that COVID-19 will disappear sooner rather than later. But during this preparation, we all are learning new skills, because in Jesus, we can be still, we can have peace, we can have hope, we can have strength, we can have courage. And so whatever the future lies ahead, we know that Jesus will be with us. And how do we know that? Because Jesus is the same yesterday and today and forever. Amen. Our closing praise is, by faith we see the hand of God.
every mood. And the power of the gospel shall prevail. For we know in Christ all things are possible. For all who call upon His name, we will stand as children of the promise. We will fix our eyes on Him, my soul's reward. Till the race is finished and the work is done, we'll walk by faith and not by sight.
And we joined together and said the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.